In this episode, I sat down with two analysts from Barrie Police, Samantha Scott and Maria McWilliams. Samantha is a new crime analyst from the Seneca College Crime and Intelligence Analysis Program, and Maria is the Information Systems Analyst with a background in IT. I asked them to talk to me about where crime analysis is heading at the Barrie Police. Here's how it went.
My name is Samantha Scott. I currently work part-time at the Barrie Police as a crime analyst student, but I'm also a full-time student at Seneca College. And I'm a part of the Bachelor of Crime and Intelligence Analysis program at King Campus.
I'm Maria McWilliams. I'm the Information Systems Analyst for the Barrie Police Service. I've been with the Barrie Police for 16 years now, so I've done this position for 5 of those years.
I started not really knowing where I wanted to go throughout this program or throughout this field, but I think as I got closer later into the program, I started doing more hands-on work, you know, learning more about data and softwares and stuff like that, and getting a good feel for the type of stuff I could potentially work on in the future. I think as I started to do that, I started to really find like a love for and a passion for like data and crime and specifics of where I wanted to go. Right when I started the program, first and second year was a bit, I don't know what I want to do, where I want to go with this. But then once third year hit, we started getting into more data-driven things, learning more about Excel and cleaning the data and then being able to visualize the data that I've been looking at. I think that's where I'm like, okay, I like doing this. I like informing people about what's going on within a jurisdiction or a city and certain trends. So I always think I knew that I wanted to go towards more a police side of it. I know our program kind of, it can venture off to different things. I know a lot of people go into like the banking industry and anti-money laundering and stuff like that. There's a lot of great opportunities within that program. But I think when I started doing more stuff with Power BI or ArcGIS and I was like, okay, I think I want to go more towards a police service and working within a police service.
My job kind of rolled into more of like what we call knowledge management. So I deal more with the data aspect of it. So I capture our data and I look for ways to transform it into useful information for the service. So whether that be the creation of dashboards or just other tools that assist officers in an investigative capacity. It's been interesting. I'm kind of everywhere. So I'm available to pretty much every unit to help them with what they need and their data requirements, as well as the obvious requirements of the service overall. That's kind of where I'm at right now. So still figuring it out.
So I got this opportunity through my program. There's a semester, I think it's the 6th or 7th semester, we have to do a co-op. So our school posted a bunch of listings and Barrie Police was fortunately one of them. So I applied to that, fortunately got the job, and then I showed up as a co-op student. I still technically am one, but my first day here, very intimidating, not gonna lie. Big place, it's a lot of people, a lot of authority. And I think the biggest thing was knowing that these people have been in this type of industry for years, like years and years. So that's just very intimidating, especially because analysis is very new to this world. So being young, being a student and introducing stuff that is still fairly new as well is intimidating altogether. So
when I think back to 5-6 years ago when we first started doing the dashboarding and seeing where we are right now, I never actually thought we would be where we are right now. I can't really tell where we're going to be in the future. I think that this is something that's going to just organically grow and become something that we've never seen. That's my thoughts on it. We're moving through our data and just the analysis with it and just exploring different ways we can use it right now. So I can't say where we're going. I know where I would like it to go. I'd like it to be everything to be evidence-based. I see the benefit of it.
I think my biggest, like what I always presumed and I always thought that analysis wasn't, like a lot of people didn't really want it, or I guess you could say, but being here, a lot of curious officers, a lot of curious people want to know about it and want to learn more about it, and especially this agency, there's just a passion for them to also want to find out and to want to and to deploy this type of thing, which I found very interesting and very refreshing to hear, because I always thought, well, I didn't always think, but I just had the impression that analysis being very new, and a lot of these people, as I mentioned, they are in this field for a long time, and I guess that change, I always thought that it wasn't wanting to happen, but a lot of people here do want it to, they encourage it, which is good. I really like knowing that they encourage this type of stuff. I guess like analysis altogether, going more deeper into as to why, like why would we do this, why would we do that? And I guess it's more of a data-driven thing. A lot of officers and stuff I know, like they don't come from the same background that I do. So I guess learning about all the data and stuff like that, having that evidence-based type of approach and wanting to go deeper into just, yeah, like I know about this and this is why I do it, but also this is why I think so. And that's because I, like through data, through mapping, through dashboards and stuff like that, it's evident that this is, it's evident that there's a reason behind other things, not just experience and stuff, you could say.
So when I started doing the dashboards 5 years ago, you know, our dashboards were very basic counts, and we were looking, you know, for trends, you know, and temporal analysis with our data. And then, you know, flash forward to now, 5 years later, and we're into evidence-based policing, including harm scores, and just looking at all our data very differently. If I look back to, you know, 5 years ago, I would never would have thought we were at this point right now. I'd like to see the service continue on with the evidence-based policing and look at new metrics, perhaps for different types of crimes, like different measurements, not focus solely on counts, but just look at different ways we can measure things. That's where I would like to see it going, but I know that'll take some time and development to get to that point.
So I work within, I guess I work more specifically within a certain unit, the high harm unit. So we have certain addresses that have been looked at as a harm spot. It drives a lot of harm throughout the city compared to others. And so we have 10 addresses. And then we also direct officers to do checks there. I think my biggest thing that I do is I'll look at certain trends throughout that address and see what kind of crimes have been happening while also looking at in comparison to the amount of checks that have been done by those officers and just seeing if there's a correlation between the two.
Our dashboards right now, we currently use for the high harm development for that team. So they use that information to deploy officers to hotspots. So that I know is what is being used for that way. As for what I would like to see it go to, I'd like to see officers maybe make more of their own decisions based on the dashboards and use the dashboarding more. Part of my job is to make tools for the officers and to make it easier for them. So that's kind of the direction I want to go.
I find that all of these people that I've been fortunate to meet and know, I think the biggest thing for me was how many people are involved with certain things. This is a big place, big facility, a lot of people are involved throughout different things, but I think I've been very fortunate to have the opportunity to learn and go through different courses. I was able to take, you know, mapping courses and meet different people about different methods that they've obtained and researched throughout their career. So I think the biggest eye-opener for me was knowing there are so many different ways to deploy strategies and methods to officers. There's, you know, the mapping aspect, there's also looking at certain trends throughout certain areas, and I think altogether just knowing that certain areas can drive up certain different crime indicators. And I'm not from Barrie, I'm not too far from Barrie, but I'm not from here, so I think just learning about a different jurisdiction and what their trends are compared to what I've learned throughout my program, because usually through my program, because where I'm located in King City, we're more focused on like the Toronto Police Services stuff. So I guess being here at Barrie, I think my biggest eye-opener was their different trends and what they see, while also learning to deploy certain softwares to be able to recognize these trends.
Aside from data cleansing, which I do, just gaining access to information, I think is probably the worst part of it all. It is my biggest challenge. The biggest problem is actually the access to data, and our IT department is fantastic here. It's more or less just extracting the data from our RMS is probably one of the most difficult things to do. I think that's a big challenge for the analysts that do work here. It's and just trying to make it into something useful. I think that is the biggest challenge we have.
My biggest challenge overall has nothing to do with data and stuff. I think my biggest challenge was just communicating with other people, whether that's to present something that I've been looking at for a couple days, or just asking for help, or because I think another thing that I learned throughout working in this field is knowing that people work better and there's better dissemination of work when a lot of people are in on it. You're not just going based off what you think, you're asking other people for their opinions, what they think, what they've found. So I think that's my biggest struggle, is having that courage to go up to someone, whether it's feedback, whether it's their opinion. But in terms of data and softwares, I think my biggest struggle is getting to learn softwares that I haven't been familiar with in the past. I've been more familiar with ArcGIS online, but luckily with the amount of all the technology that they have here, I'm able to deploy ArcGIS Pro, which is a big jump, but I'm very excited to be able to learn more about that. So I guess just having the patience for myself to learn and to deploy that, I think that's been my biggest challenge technology-wise, as well as just the cleaning of data. It's a lot bigger than just a simple assignment. You're getting it for a whole month's worth or a year's worth of data. So through what I've been around throughout these 7 months and through what I've worked with, I think the Barrie Police is going towards more an evidence-based approach. I think they're going beyond just looking at something and recognizing just a simple trend. They're going into a simple certain trend and finding out, okay, but why is this happening? What time is this happening at? And are there any specific people that are recurring throughout this area to drive this potential trend? I feel like they're really digging into the more specifics of certain things, and they're really getting into more of an evidence-based strategy and method to deploy their officers, as well as analysts and everyone else throughout the building. So I find that very refreshing and reliable as well, just to know that they're looking at all aspects of a certain situation and kind of covering all bases.
My best advice would be just remember that data is not perfect. Police data is not perfect. It's challenging to go through at times, but it'll never be perfect. You'll never have every piece of information, and just work with what you have.
Just have patience with all this stuff. I know learning a bunch of softwares can feel very overwhelming, and for first year students anyway, is to let them know that there's so many opportunities within that specific program, whether they want to go towards a police service or a bank. I think I would tell them to explore every option they have, and to not shy away from certain courses in our program because they find that they like another course better. I think if you explore everything, and then you will actually find something that you are passionate about and just follow that path, I think that's their best bet.
That's Barrie Police Analysts Samantha Scott and Maria McWilliams. Thanks for watching this episode. Click here to watch our other videos. And let me know what you think in the comments below. And do me a favor, hit that like. It really makes a difference. See you next time.